Massachusetts State Senators Cynthia Creem and Jason Lewis visited Newton North High School to talk about the newly passed Student Opportunity Act and how it will benefit students statewide and in Newton. Massachusetts consistently ranks among the top states for K-12 education, yet a highly ambitious new bill from Beacon Hill, the Student Opportunity Act, intends to devote an additional $1.5 billion to public schools over the next 7 years. On Tuesday, October 22nd, Newton North welcomed the two authors of the legislation, State Senator Jason Lewis of Winchester and State Senate Majority Leader Cynthia Creem of Newton. Mayor Ruth Ann Fuller, as well as school committee officials from Newton and Brookline, were in attendance. The bill, Senator Lewis emphasized, would increase funding and provide additional support for low-income schools and students.
We recognize, you know, this isn't just about spending more money, it's about making sure that those funds are really going to make a difference in providing a quality education for all students in all districts. And we really want that previous slide that had those persistent and troubling achievement gaps, we really want to try to, you know, finally, you know, I would hope we could completely close those, but at least let's make progress on narrowing those achievement gaps. And we know from a lot of research that what lies behind those achievement gaps is really opportunity gaps, that there's just not the same access to opportunity. And so we have to increase those opportunities for our kids, particularly in our gateway cities, low-income communities, immigrant communities, so that they have the opportunity to really achieve at their full potential.
While lawmakers in Newton and Brookline lauded the legislation and celebrated its progressive direction, they requested additional information on revenue streams and wanted to know how much the bill would cost taxpayers from higher income districts. Here's Mayor Fuller.
The vagaries of and I know why your hands are tied, but just saying it's going to be more, if you can even tell us the floor, mm-hmm. not the ceiling, anything more specific than mm-hmm. you can offer, and the sooner the better, even if you say there's a lot of uncertainty,
yeah.
and don't, you know, mm-hmm. we're grasping for some
yeah.
hard data, and waiting till January, February, March
yeah.
is really problematic.
Yeah.
The senators declined to discuss specifics, mostly for lack of explicit data. But nonetheless, school officials in both towns expressed support for the bill. Newton Superintendent David Fleischman appreciated the bill's egalitarian vision and was excited to welcome state support for low-income Newton students and school transportation.
I think local districts who can afford to pay more or support their students, we should be doing that. Obviously, we need state funding as well because we have students in need here. Who are low income, who are English learners, and so the additional funding will help, as will the additional transportation funding for our students in special education. That's something that we've needed support in for a while, and so I'm happy they included that in the bill.
Senators Lewis and Creem will continue making their case to Massachusetts education officials as the bill, which passed through the state Senate unanimously, moves to the Massachusetts House of Representatives. Ethan Plotkin, Newton News, Newtonville.